Right now, I'm here with a startup called Cloudant and Sam Bisbee, who's from Massachusetts, and Rich Levin, Dawson investor, friend of mine. So congratulations to get him to write a check.
Thank you very much.
He's a powerful, connected, cool investor.
Yeah.
You guys are down there also with a table. You guys are growing. You're profitable. You got some fresh financing to expand. Tell us about what Cloudant's doing right now. Obviously, you guys are an example of success story on the web, and it's great to see, you know, Massachusetts-based company kind of kicking the tires in the marketplace and doing well. But you got the profitability pretty fast, lean team. Now you're scaling, growing. So give us the update on Cloudant and how you see this whole world.
Sure. So we're basically trying to hit the inflection point right now. We are trying to be the data layer for web apps. And when I say web apps, I really mean any app that has data. We're built on solid open source technology, NoSQL, CouchDB, and we've been running, we forked it, put Dynamo clustering into it 2 years ago, a couple of MIT PhD physics students. And they went through Y Combinator, and they built a great service that we've been running at scale for 2 years.
So I just posted a story, not to pivot too far off what the cloud and things doing. Yep. I just wrote a story that Amazon just cut out the middleman with their cloud storage gateway. You find it a little weird that DynamoDB got a bunch of hype and AWS Storage got a small press release?
No, because it's... First of all, I want to say that we welcome DynamoDB into the market, because now we actually have a competitor. And we love competitors, and we love to mix it up. We just see it as one big validation. Also, the technical response to DynamoDB has been somewhat interesting. You know, it'll be interesting to see what the actual pricing comes out to, the actual benchmarks that it comes out. We didn't have much success running our initial public clusters on AWS because of random outages, so that's why we moved off to and partnered with SoftLayer. As far as their kind of focus, I'm really not surprised that DynamoDB got more coverage because the Dynamo white paper that they published years ago was really the first big NoSQL clustering paper that got a lot of traction, and it's named after that, so they like it.
So talk about your team at Cloudant right now. What's the makeup of the core team, and then let's talk about the market opportunity you guys have.
Sure. So the core team, we're about 12 employees right now. It's traditionally been purely Erlang gurus, really, really bright technical people, some of which are from the Apache CouchDB committer team. Recently, we announced Derek Shuttle as our CEO, and we've been bringing on a few more people to build out our field and sales staff, and yeah.
So let's talk about what it takes to compete in the market. Obviously, you're here evangelizing out cloud, and you've got a table down there. Great developer community here, and kind of a business crowd, kind of a perfect storm. It's not too much of a geek conference per se. You got JF Conf, which tickets will go on sale here pretty shortly, like today or tomorrow. So it's kind of that crowd, but you guys have to compete. What is, and obviously joint with huge financing is demonstrating this fully integrated cloud, turnkey, making it simpler. What are you guys doing in that market opportunity? How are you competing? And your offering.
How are we competing against Joint?
No, just in general, what's the market opportunity for you guys? What's your differentiation? What's your solution set? And what's your value proposition that you pitch to customers?
I mean, when we're talking to business people, which this conference primarily is, we start to really talk about removing the DBA role. And you know, it's not that the DBA role is going to disappear from Monster.com. It's that we're trying to make it easier.
Oracle doesn't like that, do they?
No, they don't. But, you know, a lot of the people that we deal with are running, screaming, and crying from Oracle. Or, you know, they can't afford $100,000.
Yeah.
And so, you know, we're trying to be that kind of agnostic data layer for any application where, you know, we can go in your data center, you can talk to our private cloud, you can come into our data center if you want to. We've got everybody from free accounts who don't care as much about latency to, you know, real-time bidding ad agencies where we've got, you know, we have to respond within milliseconds on the same LAN. So it's,
Are you onboarding developers primarily or businesses or both? What's your, because Joyent got that nice, and Heroku made a killing by onboarding app developers and kind of prefabricating some of those resources?
I mean, right now, as far as if you want to talk about corporate strategy, it's not like we're going out there and wining and dining CTOs.
Yeah, you don't have the cash for that.
Yeah. We're really trying to focus on...
Maybe a few Red Sox tickets because everyone loves Fenway. But right,
absolutely.
You know.
No, we are Patriots, which we will be winning the Super Bowl, by the way. We're really trying to go after developers now and, you know, high-tech companies that are small. That being said, we weren't planning on going after enterprise, and yet enterprise has been knocking down our door.
Why?
They get it. They get it from a business prop, and they get it from a technical prop.
Is it the scalability or the security?
It's the scalability, but it's also the fact that we can get updated, queryable data to their platform faster. So to use the technical talk, it's because we CouchDB, even the open source version, has what's called incremental MapReduce. And this allows us to get you updated indexes within seconds instead of rebuilding your index over 3 days.
So explain incremental MapReduce versus what people know about Hadoop and traditional MapReduce. What's the difference between the two?
Right. So Hadoop, Mongo, any of these guys, even if you go to the SQLs, basically, it could take you 3 hours or 3 days to build your index. That could be, you know, primary key index. That could be any kind of index. You could be using Lucene. Incremental MapReduce, you have to do that initial large build of the index. After that, we are able to represent new updates to the primary data set into that index within seconds. And so that's huge for analytics companies, business intelligence, really anybody who cares about data being fresh.
So what do you think about nodes? Let's talk about Node Summit. Obviously, Node.js is a rapid rise in the energy and multiple communities kind of coming together. Node community is dynamic, it's respectful, and very professional developers. What's your take of this and opportunity for Node?
Well, I think Node is just going to keep growing. It's one of those things where JavaScript is extremely accessible. You know, it's going to be interesting because PHP seemed to have gone through a very similar life cycle. It was extremely accessible. People started to standardize on it. And so it's going to be interesting to see over the next, let's say, year, to see if the pool just gets really crowded. You know, PHP didn't do a good job of managing all the people who wanted to get on the bandwagon. And I love PHP. I still code in PHP. But, you know, not many people can claim to be good at PHP. There's a lot of bad people on it. And so it's going to be interesting to see how the community kind of handles that.
Yeah. Okay, we're here with Sam Bisbee from Cloudant, a great growing company, classic success story. And it's kind of an East Coast success story, although they have a maverick investor in Rich Levendorf from Avalon Ventures, also invested in Zynga and a lot of the big, you know, web companies. So he knows, he's been around the block and, for many, many cycles. So you got a really strong investor, great validation, self-financed, some seed, Y Combinator success story. Congratulations on your success and good luck with everything. Great to come on theCUBE.
Thank you very much.